I'm gonna show you everything you need to know about conditional formats and Coda, as well as why they might be the problem that your doc is actually slowing down. And if you stay till the very end, I'm gonna show you how to do some crazy stuff like this with any custom color you may ever want. Let's go. So first we're just gonna learn about how to use conditional formats and put them on your tables, but specifically just for aesthetics. We're not gonna do any conditional pieces yet where the colors change. We're just gonna use them to make our documents look pretty. So first let's just look at how to access them. We're gonna go to options. There's always multiple ways to find this. We can go options, conditional format, and then we can start adding rules. You can also find it simply from the column level as well if you want to put a format on the name, for example. You can go ahead and go to conditional format in here. Format, conditional format, okay? That will start one for task name. What you're going to do then, if you just want it for aesthetics, here's a little trick. You actually don't need to worry about this at all. Just put something on it. And you'll notice that that applies to every single row, and that'll apply to new rows that happen as well too. New row, okay? So that's one way we can make it beautiful, right? We wanna make just something else stand out a bit more. Maybe we'll make our description be italic and gray, right? So that is already starting to add just some visual aesthetics to our table, making it look just a bit prettier. One more thing we can do, and this is a really fun trick, so stay with me if you haven't seen this before. Right here we have a team. This is our marketing team. This is our product team. It's just hard to tell these that they're actually different, right? Because it's all the same color. So I'm gonna show you a really fun way to add a new color to that. On the team table, which this is actually pulling from, I've made an auto number field. So how you make an auto number field like this that numbers upwards is you just use a quick formula that is this table, dot find this row. Put that on, it will auto number. What I'm gonna do now is add a conditional format to this number that is actually a gradient. So when you have a number column, it will give you a color scale option. I'm gonna apply that also though to the team as well. And once I do, if I go back to my table, you'll see now that my marketing is this nice purple and my product is this nice blue. So our table's looking way better than when we first started. Next though, we're gonna look at how to use it actually conditionally. We're gonna see, okay, what if the due date is overdue, right? If a task is actually overdue and late, we want to be able to show that really quick to the user. So let's go see how we do that now. All right, so in order to do this, what you're gonna do is open up your conditional formats once again. So in these pieces, we didn't do anything with contains or actually the value whatsoever. This time we are though, we're gonna put a conditional format on the due date. So we said we wanted to color something if it was due, if it's overdue, or maybe it's due today. Let's start with just today. So you'll notice this says day due is equal to, I can do is after, is before, we can say is before today, for example. If the due date is before today, that is overdue. We are gonna make it red. So now you'll see that I'm actually filming this on January 3rd. That's what today is, right? If I go into here, shows you that today is January 3rd. So obviously this is in the future and these are all in the past. And because these are in the past, we are coloring them red. But there's a problem here, right? Because we don't wanna say, hey, this is red, this is a problem, because this is actually not overdue, this is done. So how are we gonna do that? How are we going to only format the due date red if it's in the past and it is not done, not completed yet. So what we're gonna do here is when you start a conditional formatting rule, you can start with a formula right away, right? Or you can take something you've built and you can transition it to a formula to give yourself more flexibility. So if I'm gonna transition this to a formula, we're saying, hey, if this row's due date is less than today, color it red. But I'm gonna say two things. I'm gonna say if it's less than today and its status is not equal to, and that's how we say not equal to, as an exclamation point and then an equal sign. We could say if it's not equal to, done. Boom. And now you'll notice that this one, even though that date is in the past, it's not showing us as red because it's done. You'll see this one, watch, now this will change in real time. If I change this to done, you'll see that that turns back. And if I change this to the future, I change that to red. So that's conditional formats and how you can use them conditionally to show your information. But I will warn you, conditional formats are one of the biggest reasons your docs will slow down. So let's take a look at that next and why that might happen. All right, so if you have a doc that is slow, right? You're pressing buttons, you're adding rows, and it just feels so laggy and clunky. There's a lot of reasons why that might be happening, and we actually do doc audits, so we can actually audit your doc and figure out exactly what's going on and make your docs fast again. So reach out in the comments below or look at the description if you wanna look into that. But one of the biggest culprits of these slow docs are actually conditional formats. Conditional formats are these large formulas running over large tables, and they can oftentimes cause you a lot of pain and a lot of slowness. So how I like to think about conditional formats is all they do is they help users understand your data better. And in order to help your users understand data, you have a lot of tools at your disposal, not just conditional formatting. So let's say that we realize, this conditional format, our doc is so slow, let's just delete it, right? Okay, that's gone. But we still need users to be able to notice when things are overdue. Well, what you can do is you can add a filter, right? So let's go ahead, or you can add a new view. Let's just call one overdue tasks. We can then take the task table and we can just filter it to where the due date is before today and the status is not done. I have a whole video on filters if you want to look at them, why we're doing this. I break this all down in another video if you want to check that out. But right now what you're seeing is you're seeing only overdue tasks. You'll notice that all these are in the past, and then I can even sort them by the due date. So I see the most overdue tasks right away, right? So instead of using conditional formatting, we could just use a specific view and sort it and filter it to show the user what we're actually looking for. So that is how I would avoid it. If you have a slow doc, honestly, one of the first things you can actually do is take all your conditional formats and just delete them. Unless they're like this, right? These visual ones don't have any formulas, aren't doing anything. They are gonna be a bit faster and more performant. Next up, and the last thing we're gonna look at is actually a hidden secret Coda formula that allows you to input any colors into your doc whatsoever. So what the formula is a formula called gradient. In order to use gradient, what we're first gonna need to do is have a column that has numbers in it. So we need a number column to define our color. So let's say we wanted to use this for custom colors. Let's say we wanted to put our branding colors as the background for description, okay? So let's just say equal to one. Okay, great. Now they all have a number. I'm gonna turn this into a number. And what I'm gonna do now is go to my conditional formats and I'm gonna add a rule. And I'm gonna say formula. What you're gonna need to do here is type in an underscore, as you see down there. And then in all capitals, you're gonna put gradient. Okay, notice that nothing comes up, but the moment we put a parentheses, notice that it has this little experimental thing. So it's not gonna show, but it still is gonna work for you. And the value that we're gonna use is the number that you just created. So the number we just created was the number. The stop value is one. There's a whole documentation I'll show you on this later, how this works specifically. I'm just gonna demonstrate how it works and you can dive into it more on your own. But now with that one, I'm gonna define the color that I want. So I want 144F7D. If you don't know what that is, that's a hex code. It defines custom color values. So we'll do that, and now you'll see, all of this got changed to that color. I'm not gonna apply that to all columns, I'm gonna apply it just to the description, and then I'm also going to put the description, because it's so dark, I'm gonna make the description have a more custom white wording. So now I've got this custom blue color that I could have not gotten before. So you'll be able to change that as well, right? I can change this to anything I want. I can change this to EE733E. And all of a sudden now you'll see that that changes to a custom orange, and you can do whatever you would like with those. You can also change this and have them go to all sorts of different colors. So here, this is the link. If you want this link, it goes through the formula gradient in great detail. So you'll see exactly how this formula works, how to insert formulas, colors, how to insert stop values so you work with custom conditional formats. It was made by a team member of ours named Jono, and you can find this link in the comments below. Last thing I'm gonna say about these kind of formulas like gradient that allows you to do custom things, they are experimental, so they are prone to breaking. So use them at your own risk, but they are fun and provide a lot of different flexibility. Any other questions about conditional formatting? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks, guys.